Inshallah, as we said before, my dear brothers, the names of Allah keep us in connection with Allah and help us, enable us to worship Allah with His names. So the ulama, they said, as we said before, ihsa, to memorize the names of Allah is not enough. You have to memorize it, understand it, make dua by using it, and worship Allah with this quality. It means this displayed in our behavior. Like, we believe that Allah is the Razzaq, we should not do anything wrong. We should not believe in other people. We should not earn haram just to get the rizq. So if we do that, it means even if you memorize the Razzaq, our example is like someone who is very stingy, he doesn't spend. And he memorized the word of Allah in the Quran, وَأَنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And he said with the proper tajweed. He do the ikhfa in the noon, and he do perfect tajweed with it. But he doesn't spend. Did he understand this ayah?
No.
No. So same thing with the names of Allah. Names of Allah is not only to memorize and understand. You have to display it in your behavior and in your life. So today, inshallah, we enter in the three names, inshallah, together. May Allah help us in the time. The names of Allah that we are going to discuss today are three. First is Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, As-Salaam. Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, As-Salaam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم. We talk about it before and we mention it in details, الرحمن الرحيم. Today we say, we talk about Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, As-Salaam. In the Quran, the Malik has been written in many verses in three different ways. Al-Malik, Malik, Al-Malik. Three words. The people who are in North Africa and they read the riwayah of Warsh and some countries of Africa, they read Al-Fatiha, not Malik Yawmiddin. They read Malik Yawmiddin. And between bracket, some people, when they saw the Quran of Warsh in some masajid, look, subhanAllah, how we hear, some people have narrow-minded. They thought that this Quran is modified, so they want to throw it from the rack of the masjid. You have to understand that the Quran comes with seven lahjat, seven tongues. So Warsh and Nafi'a and Qalun, there are so many Qurans, but they are all the same, small differences. Like if you, for example, go to Mauritania, they are very strict with the Makhraj. And if you read Malik Yawmiddin, the whole Masjid will correct you. They will say Malik Yawmiddin, because in Warsh, it's called Malik. Now what is the difference? Malik, Malik and Malik. Malik is the one who owns something, but he cannot rule. For example, you said, I own this house. I own this house. Or I own this place. In Canada, it's good to say, I own this house. You own this house, but you cannot rule. Because if the property tax from the city increase, you cannot say, I'm not going to pay. Even though this is your own house. So the one who owns and does not rule or govern is called Malik. The Malik is the one who govern and rule, but he cannot own. The king of the country cannot own the whole country. Maybe he owns palaces and lands and companies, but he cannot own the whole lands, the whole country. So the king of a country, it's not necessary owner. He's not Malik. So Malik is the one who rule and govern the whole country, the whole state. And Malik is the one who own. Malik has been used only in Akhirah and Jannah. إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَهَرٍ فِي مَقْعَدِ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ مَلِيكٍ وِذْيَا مَلِيكٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ. Why Allah used the Malik? Ulama, they said, Malik is صِغَةَ الْمُبَالَغَةَ دِيَ الْمُلْكِ. صِغَةَ الْمُبَالَغَةَ, it means the top kingdom. Because in the Day of Judgment, the ruler who have been tyrant and they were not believer, they will be in hell. And in Jannah, all the people who are pious, they will be in Jannah. So who rule, who decide, who give the enjoyment and the punishment to the tyrant is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Malik. Sighat al-mubalagha, excessive mulk. The kings that cannot be negotiated or challenged. Now my dear brothers, scholars, they said the word Ism Allah al-Malik. Ism Allah al-Malik, what does it mean? The mulk of Allah, the kingdom of Allah, can never be decreased. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah say, لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Who can minimize the kingdom of Allah or minimize the property of Allah? Who? That's why one pious man, when he wants to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he went to Abdullah ibn Adham, he told him, tell me five words. If I can do, if you convince me, I will stop committing sin. He says, don't disobey him and you eat his food. Don't disobey him and you live in his land. You understand? So the whole world is belonging to Allah. So the kingdom of Allah cannot be decreased, cannot be challenged. You know, kings, they fight with each other. Who can fight Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Cannot be challenged. The kingdom of Allah is forever. It has, it's limitless. There is no limit to the kingdom of Allah. لَهُ الْمُلْكُ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَمِنْ بَعْدُ. He has the kingdom in this dunya and the akhirah. And the kingdom of Allah, my dear brothers, has no example. And a king, when he ruled for a short time. But the kingdom of Allah has no example, because the kingdom of Allah is real. The true kingdom is the kingdom of Allah. That's what Rasulullah says, Allahu Malikul Muluk wa Rabbul Arbab. Allah is the King of Kings and the Lord of all these makhluqat. Whatever He wills happen and whatever He decides will be proceed. No one can challenge His decision, no one can reject His will or go out from His will. That's why Rasulullah said in the Hadith Qudsi, Allah said in the Hadith Qudsi, مَنْ لَمْ يَرْضَ بِقَضَائِي, whosoever is not pleased with my destiny, وَلَمْ يَشْكُرْ لِنَعْمَائِي, and he is not thankful to my bounties, وَلَمْ يَصْبِرْ عَلَى بَلَائِي, and he is not patient on my test, فَلْيَخْرُجْ مِنْ أَرْضِ وَسَمَائِي, let him come out from my earth and sky, and heavens and earth, وَلْيَبْتَغِ لَهُ رَبًّا سِوَايَ, and let him seek another king. Now the kingdom of the makhluq, the kingdom of makhluq is limited. A king can rule place or country or a continent or even the whole world, but he cannot control the whole world. Like in Namrud, did he control Canada or North America? That time they used to call it the ocean of darknesses. From Morocco, they think that there is no land. So the king of the makhluq is limited. The king of the makhluq can be taken by somebody else. And as you say, my dear brothers, in the history we read, any kingdom whenever reach to the top, it start decline, then other people take over and kill the kings or put him in a jail. And that's why Harun al-Rashid, when they spread the rumor that Harun al-Rashid is going to die, he called a Persian doctor. Harun Rashid, he used to go to the, look to the cloud, and he used to say, go wherever you go. The kharaj, kharaj is the zakat of whatever the land gave from the crops or whatever. The kharaj of that land that come through the crops of that rain will come to me. He has such big kingdom. So Harun Rashid, my dear brothers, when he got so sick, he called a Persian doctor. And he says, the Persian doctor, he says, don't tell them that the king is sick. Tell him that someone in the hospital, the palace is sick. So the Persian doctor, well, very sharp doctor, he says, give me sample of his urine. So when he heard that he needed the urine, he says, okay, mix urine of some people with mine. So they brought him 10 samples from 10 people, and one of them is Harun al-Rashid. So he looked to the tent, and he secluded the Harun Rashid sample and says, tell to the owner of this bottle, because they put some initials that he doesn't understand. He says, tell to the owner of this ocean to write his last will. All his organs are completely defected. أَخْبِرُ صَاحِبَ هَذَا الْقَدْرِ أَنْ يُوَصِّي فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ خَارَتْ قِوَاهِ. So Harun Rashid, when he knows that he is going to die, He say a poet. He says, "Inna al-tabiba bi tibbihi wa dawa'ihi." Doctor, the sharp doctor with all his medicine and all his experience, لا يستطيع دفع نحب إذا أتى. He cannot push away the debt when it's come. ما بال الطبيب يموت بالداء الذي قد كان أبرد ناسه من فيما مضى. How come the doctor that used to cure all the disease die with the same disease? عجز المداوي والمداوى والذي جلب الدواء ومن باع ومن اشترى. He said everyone is unable front of the will of Allah. The doctor, the sick man, the medicine, the man who brought the prescription, and the man who said it. All of them are unable front of the will of Allah. Then when he was dying, he looked to the sky and says, Ya man lam yazal mulkahu. Oh, you're the one that his kingdom never perish. Irham man zala mulkahu. Have mercy on the man whose kingdom has been perished now. So Harun Rashid did not took with him his palaces. He did not took with him his kingdom. He went with a piece of cloth. You understand, my dear brother? So this is the kings of the dunya. And that's why, my dear brother, it has a report, and this is Israeliyat, but it's good to take a lesson of it. Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Fajr, Iram. Iram, it's a paradise. That Allah mentioned in the Quran in Surah Al-Fajr, he says, Iram adatil imad. التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. No one creates such paradise like this. A kingdom, a king, that time, when he heard, and some they said it's Bakhtar Nasr, anyway, one king, when he heard about the Prophet, how he described Jannah, he did not follow the Prophet. He says, that Jannah that you talk about, I will make it in this dunya. So he make palaces of gold and silver, and it took many years. So when they completed, and they told him, call him to come, the Prophet come to him on the way. He says, believe that Allah is the one who enabled you to do all this. Believe in Allah who give you all this. He says, this was not Allah who give me. It is my kingdom, my power. So Allah sent the angel of death, and he took his soul before he entered that palace, that paradise. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who decided in this king, in his kingdom. And that's why Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf Thaqafi, when he becomes so tyrant and he kills so many people, the last person he killed is Sa'id ibn Jubayr, great scholar. And when Sa'id ibn Jubayr was almost going to die, he says, Oh Allah, don't make him kill anyone after me. Great scholar, the Ummah need him. He was from the great Tabi'in and he has so much knowledge. And the Ummah need that alim, but he killed him. Hasan al-Basri, when he heard that Hajjaj became so tired that he killed Sa'id ibn Jubayr, that he used to finish the Quran in one rak'ah, like Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. So when he heard that he killed him, he raised his hand and say, Ya Qasim al-Jababira, O the one who break the tyrant, break al-Hajjaj. So in 3 days, he died. 3 days. And that's why, my dear brothers, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the angel to blow the trumpet and everybody will die, Allah will say the first word, he says, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ. To whom belongs the kingdom today? Every tyrant, every ruler, every rich, every billionaire, they are dead. Allah will answer himself. 3 times nobody answered him, and he answered himself, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. So when the day of judgment come, all these kings, they will come naked, they will come hungry, thirsty, and they will come disgraced front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will say, Ayna al-jabbarun? Ayna al-mutakabbirun? Where are the tyrants? Where are the arrogant? So my dear brothers, the kingdom belongs to Allah. How we can worship Allah with the name Malik? Ulama, they said, when you stand up before Allah in Salat, and this is very sad. Let's be frank, my dear brothers. Wallah al-Alim, it is very sad. If someone have an interview, or if someone is talking in front of a policeman, ask him something serious, or if, for example, some people come from a high level to his house to talk to him, knock his door, or let's say, for example, even on the phone, he got the call from immigration or from Revenue Canada The man becomes so focused, he cannot look at right and left, and he tells everybody, quiet, turn off the any noise, let me focus, let me listen. But when we stand up before Allah, we do all kind of the wrong things, as if we have no importance to whom we are standing in front of. You are standing in front of Al-Malik. And Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam, when he gave example to the Salat, what he says? He says the example of Salat is like a man who sends a request to meet the king, so his needs can be fulfilled. So after many years, he got the letter from the king, telling him, come such day, at such time, king will meet you to fulfill all your needs. How happy he will be. So when he entered to the king, and then the people of the palace put him inside the main reception, and the king came in front of him and tell him, okay, I answer your letter, I read it, and I'm in front of you now, tell me your needs. He start look to the marble of the wall, and look to the fountains and the beauty of the palace, and the king kept telling him, what is your need? And he kept just looking to the beauty of the palace. So the king got so much angry, and he says, king, kick him out. Yahya said this example, and this example is revelation by Allah to Yahya. It means, when you are sitting in Salat, all your worries, all your problems, all your concern can be resolved in two rak'at if your heart is devoted. If your heart is devoted and you're connected with Allah, all your needs can be fulfilled through the Salat. But unfortunately, our Salat, we cannot even benefit the minimum thing through it. Also, my dear brothers, scholar, they said, time is running. The second name after Al-Malik is Al-Quddus. Al-Quddus. And Al-Quddus is similar to the Tasbih. Qadasa, Qadis, Al-Qadis, or Al-Qadas. Al-Qadas, the Arab they call Qadas, is the container of water that they used to take bath with it, clean themselves with it. So Quddus means the purifier. Allah purify. And Quddus also come from al-ard al-muqaddasa, which is al-mubaraka. Shay muqaddas mubarak. Al-ard allati barakna hawlahu. It means Allah bless that land of the Masjid al-Aqsa. Ulama, they said, because majority of the prophets are buried there. So their blessed body is buried in that land. That's why it's called Ard al-Muqaddasa. The Quddus, my dear brothers, scholar, they said, is the one who is free from any incomplete qualities, any ayib, any deficiencies. And what is the difference between Tasbih and Taqdis? Tasbih is to nazih Allah amma la yaliqu bih. Like, for example, you say, Allah does not have a son, subhanallah. If someone non-believer tell you, Allah has son, first word you react to this word, subhanallah. It means you free Allah from these attributes of incomplete qualities. Taqdis is you approve to Allah the good qualities. You understand? For example, Allah is one, tuqaddisu. Allah la yanam, does not sleep, tuqaddisu. فَتَقَدَّسَ اللَّهُ عَنِ النَّوْمِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, مُقَدَّسَ عَنِ النَّوْمِ مُقَدَّسَ عَنِ السَّهُ وَالنِّسْيَانِ لَا يَدِلُّ رَبِّي وَلَا يَنْسَى. Allah does not sleep, Allah does not forget, Allah does not have a partner, Allah has no example, Allah his end is just, he is not unjust. So this is called taqdis. And Allah يُقَدِّسَ الْعِبَادِ, it means he purify them. And that's why Rasulullah, my dear brothers, he used to say in the ruku' and the sujood, Subhana Subuh al-Quddus, Rabbul Malaikati wal-Ruh. This dua, Subuh al-Quddus, Rabbul Malaikati wal-Ruh, it is very important to memorize, because it is authentic to say, it is masnoon to say this dua in the ruku' and in the sujood. Rasulullah, all the time after saying Subhana Rabbi al-Adim 3 times, he used to say Subuh al-Quddus, Rabbul Malaikati wal-Ruh. And in the witr, my dear brothers, when he finished all the a'mal of the night, tahajjud and istighfar and dua, last word he say after the witr, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, 3 times. 3rd time he raised the voice with it. And why he said the Quddus at the end of the a'mal? Ulama, they said, because no matter how much you do to attribute to Allah, to praise Allah, to do tasbih to Allah, you are unable. So Rasulullah say, after finishing all these a'mal, Subhuh al-Quddus, Rabbu al-Malaikati wal-Ruh. The angel, my dear brothers, when Allah wants to create Adam, قالوا, the angel, they told Allah, أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء. You will create such human being that will spread bloodshed and do the sin. ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك. We are the one who do taqdis. It means, هنا salat, we pray for you. We glorify you. So to taqdis, when you do subhanallah, when you do the tasbih, the ta'zim, alhamd, this is all taqdis of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how we can worship Allah with Quddus, my dear brothers? Ulama, they said, to free ourselves from the sin. When you make tawbah, you display on your the name of Quddus. And whenever you need something to purify yourself from, to get purified from haram earning, from rude tongue that hurts people, from bad habits, ask Allah with this name Quddus. Ya Allah, Ya Quddus, tahirni, purify you from this. Use this name to clean yourself from any wrong, from any bad habits. Use this name Quddus. That's why, my dear brothers, sometimes we mix up the names. We ask Allah to purify us, we say, Ya Razzaq, or Ya Ghafur. No. You have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proper question with the proper name. فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. Use the proper name for the proper dua. Last inshallah name, my dear brother, is the Salam. And Salam, my dear brothers, is the name of Allah. That's why Khadija radiallahu anha, when Jibreel came to meet Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Khadija radiallahu anha was coming with food. Rasulullah was exhausted, sitting in the corner in Mecca. Khadija was coming and she did not see Jibreel. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, when he looked to the woman coming, he turned to Rasulullah, who is this? So he says, this is Khadija, this is my wife. So he told him, As-Salaam yuqri'uha As-Salaam. As-Salaam means Allah, send her salam. Yani ajib, look at the maqam of this woman. Yani it is not Jibreel, when he was talking with Rasulullah and Aisha passed by, Jibreel say, who is this? He told him, this is Aisha. He says, if she have said salam wa alaikum, I will answer him. I will answer her wa alaikum salam. So Jibreel would have answered Aisha salam wa alaikum. But Khadija radiallahu anha, Jibreel come with the salam from Allah to her specially. He says, as-salam yuqri'uha as-salam. Now look how this woman has the knowledge, she has so much understanding. She said, when Rasulullah told her, oh Khadija, Allah send you salam. As-salam yuqri'uka as-salam. Hada Jibreel, this is Jibreel who told me this news, that Allah send you salam. So she said, huwa as-salam. Wa ala Jibreel wa alayka as-salam. You understand? She did not say wa alaykum as-salam. You cannot say to Allah wa alaykum as-salam. Because Allah is the salam. Look how she has deep understanding. She said in the answer, when Allah sent her salam, she said, he is the salam. To Jibreel and to you, alaykum salam. So salam means peace. Peace. As-salam means peace. Allah sent this revelation and this guidance and all the prophets to spread peace, to spread mercy. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. If the rahmah spread, there will be killing. Why all these a'mal? Why Allah say, don't do that? Why you don't do? Why you don't backbite? Why you don't steal? Why you don't hurt? Why you don't kill? Why you don't commit adultery? Why you don't slander people? Why? To spread peace. Peace. So shaitan will have no job. What he will do? How he will work on you? You already have peace on everybody. Your heart is clean. There is no jealousy. There is no arrogance. So this is called peace. That's why Rasulullah call us, Allah call us from this name, al-Muslimin, from Salam. Rasulullah say, al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimun min lisanihi wa yadih. The Muslim, the true Muslim is the one that the Muslim are safe from his tongue and from his hand. And Rasulullah say, afshu salam baynakum, spread salam. Look, subhanAllah, to our greeting. As-Salam, peace on you. Wa alaikum salam, and peace to you too. Adam, when Allah created him, tell him, go to the angel to teach you salam. He tell him, salamu alaikum. He says, wa alaikum salam, wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. And my dear brothers, scholar, they said that Allah in Jannah, first word he will utter when he meets the people of Jannah, he says, As-Salaamu Alaikum. Allah will give salam. Salamun qawlan min Rabbin Rahim. In the Jannah. That's why ulama, they said, how we can display salam on us? We should make people safe from us. Al-mu'minu man aminahu muslimun ala dima'ihim wa amwalihim. Safe from us. You don't hurt people by your backbiting. Your heart is clean. You don't have jealousy. You don't hate Muslim. You cannot hate Muslim. This is, my dear brother, what does it mean, salam? Salam of Allah, it will display on you by having clean heart. Peace on everybody. You spread salam on anyone. You don't spread people to people that you know. You don't say salam alaikum to the people of your tribe. You say salam alaikum to any Muslim. Also, my dear brother, how we display salam in our life, scholar, they said, we should use this word. Rasulullah, when he finished tahiyyat, after salam alaikum, he used to say, Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam. Tabarakta ya dal jalali wal ikram. Use this word. It has an effect. It is masnoon to say it after each salat. Also, scholar, they said, my dear brothers, the salam comes from the salama. Salama means to be safe from the sin. And that's why the people who are safe from the major sin in this dunya, ulama, they said, Allah will save them from hell in the bridge of Sirat. Because in the bridge of Sirat, everybody will say, Allahumma sallim, sallim. Oh Allah, safeguard, safeguard. So the display of the name salam in the dunya, we should say, Allahumma sallimni min al-dhunub. Oh Allah, safeguard me from the sin. So the word, the name of Allah, salam, can be used to be safeguard from the fitna, safeguarded from the sin, and to have clean heart on all the Muslims. Allah yafqna iyyakum. Assalamu alaikum.